गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। और बेसिकली दोस्तों, आज हम लोग बात करने वाले हैं डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स को लेकर, ठीक है। और आज बिकॉज ऑफ नेटवर्क इश्यूज मेरे ऑफिस में लाइट भी नहीं है, तो आई एम टेकिंग क्लास थ्रू दिस स्क्रीन रिकॉर्डिंग ऑनली, राइट। तो मेन पढ़ने से मतलब है, मेरा थोबड़ा देख के कोई मतलब है नहीं, राइट। यस, सो टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद दिस ऑनली, राइट। सो आई होप एवरीवन हैज जॉइंड। शुड वी स्टार्ट नाउ? यस, परफेक्ट परफेक्ट। गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन, वन एंड ऑल। वी आर सपोज टू स्टार्ट टुडे विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, जिसका नाम है डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स, ठीक है। डीपीज वी कैन कॉल इट ऑल्सो एज अ डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स, डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ स्टेट। नाउ प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, देर आर टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स। वन इज कॉल्ड एज एफ आर एंड वन इज कॉल्ड एज डीपी, राइट। देर आर टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स, एफ आर एंड डीपी। सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड वट इज मीनिंग ऑफ एफ आर एंड डीपी, राइट। एफ आर, fundamental rights, DP, directive principles. Now both are very important things to understand what I'm trying to teach you, right? Both are important topics to understand, directive principles and fundamental rights. Now what is fundamental rights, sir? It is compulsory. It is compulsory. Compulsory. Fundamental rights are compulsory and every state make sure that every citizen should get the fundamental rights, right? It is written in the FR, fundamental rights. But when we talk about DP, I hope you can understand these two words, directive principles. Can you guess this DP? Can anyone tell me the word DP? Full form of DP is directive principles. Can anyone try it and give me a logic? DP, directive principle. Any guess? Full form is okay, directive principles. Can anyone tell me the meaning of these two words, directive principles? Or rather, as usual, I will give you one example. I'll give you one example, right? In our example of contract, Tushar Pahade is supposed to receive fees, right? Students are supposed to receive the lectures. Achha, I have also told you that to revise whatever I have taught. Revise whatever I have taught. Okay, revise whatever I have been taught to you. And I will tell one more example. You also told us, Tushar sir, can you please take a what you say? Can you teach us the subject of BCom? In BCom also, in graduation also, we have some one topic called as law. Okay, so in graduation, we have a B law, business law, right? Now these are the four examples which I have took. Please understand my point. Can you tell me in these four examples what are the rights? Actually, frankly speaking, none of this is fundamental rights. None of this is. But can you try to understand what are the rights of a person in this example? And what are the principles, directive principles? Any guess? I know this example is not perfect, but I'm just trying to teach you in a some different manner. If you understand, if you able to crack these four answers, you will understand what I'm trying to teach you. Can you tell me in this example? I'm waiting for the comments. I'm able to see the comments also. If anyone can quickly comment, what are the fundamental rights in this example? In this example, though actually these are not fundamental rights, I am just trying to take in as example, what are the rights and what are the principles? Anyone can say directive principles, directive principles. What do you think? Yes. Jatin Ahuja says fees and lectures are the fundamental rights. Okay. Some more people. Sapna, Prachi, Isha, Om, Ankita, Akshay, where is Krishna Sarda, Siddharth Sarda, Likhita. Many people are missing today. anyone can tell try to Jatin has told me something. Yes, please tell me. Fine. Okay. So the answer is simple. Look, if I'm teaching you, it is my fundamental right to receive fees from you, right? And since you are paying fees, it is your fundamental right to receive lectures. So this can be categorized as rights. So why rights? Because if you do not get, if I don't get fees, can I file a case on you? Yes, sir. If I do not get fees, can I file a case on you? Yes, sir. If you do not get lectures after paying fees, can you file a suit on us? Yes, sir. So these two are very much example of rights. Actually, these are not fundamental rights. I hope you are able to understand. Okay? Don't say, Tushar sir, aap galat padha rahe ho. These are not fundamental rights. Yes, I also know these are not fundamental rights. I am just trying to compare you. But when I said you revise whatever I have been taught, can it be fundamental right of Tushar Pahade? Can I make sure that have you revised or not? If I ask you, yes, Prachi Maheshwari, good. These two are examples of DP. So what is DP? Directive principle. What is directive principle? Tushar Pahade has given you direction. What direction? That whenever we complete the syllabus, you go and revise everything. It is my direction. But agar maan lo aapne nahi padha, if you do not revise at home, what should I do? Tell me. Tell me in the comment section, what will I do? If you do not give me fees, can I file a suit on you? Can I file a case file kar sakta hu, agar aap fees nahi denge to? Answer is yes. But if I told you that go and revise whatever I have taught you, go and revise. If you do not revise, what should I do? Can I file a case on you? Answer is obviously no. I can't file a case on you because it is a directive principle and you should do. आपने करना चाहिए. यू सेड तुषार सर ग्रेजुएशन में वी हैव अ बिजनेस लॉ, कैन यू टीच अस? ये मेरी मर्जी. इफ यू रिक्वेस्ट मी, आई मे डू इट. यस, आई मे नॉट डू इट. नो. सो इट इज माई विश. आई मे नॉट डू. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड माई पॉइंट. डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स. सो वॉट आर द मीनिंग डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टू थिंग्स? इफ आई टॉक अबाउट FR and if I talk about DP, what do you think? What could be the difference between FR and DP? So you can understand FR are enforceable and DPs are not enforceable. Can you file a suit on this? Suit can be filed. यहां पे no suit. No suit. So finally you can say FR are superior. Can you say like this? Can you say FR are superior? Yes, Jatin. Whatever you are saying, I am writing this only. If you can see this. Can we say FR are superior and DPs are not, I will not say inferior, I will say subordinate. Can we say like this? Can you say like this, right? I request you to, can you take a snapshot of this also and you can put in the group also, right? So that you have a revision for revision purpose, you will always have this thing. So can we say these three words? FR are enforceable, fundamental rights. If anyone writes, you can file a suit on that person. Yes, sir. And you can say fundamental rights are superior. DPs are always subordinate. And whatever Jatin said, I hope you can everyone read the comment of Jatin. Sir, can we say that principles are not necessary or mandatory? Yes, obviously. Principles are something which are good to be done. If you can do it, it's good. If you are not able to do it, that's good. We can't help it. You know. Abhi now I said around, you can say 14 people are watching video, but only 6 to 7 people are commenting. Right now 14-15 people are watching video and only 7 people are commenting. What about 7 people? Sir, they are not commenting. There are 2-3 people who never comment. I know the name of the people, but I'll not take the name right now. But I always ask, please comment, they never comment. So can I file a suit on this those people? No, because it is a directive principle that if you comment, if you come forward, if you interact, it will be helpful for each other. But if you do not do all these things, can I file a suit? No. Because DPs are subordinate. I hope you understand. Always I say, Jatin Ahuja, do not reply first. But what Jatin do? He always give a reply first. I always said Jatin, sorry, not to reply first, but always he do it. So what is this example? Now Jatin will say, sir, it's my fundamental right. I should reply. And my point was, whatever I said to Jatin is the example of what? DP, directive principles. Because I want that before Jatin, other people should reply. Other people should get a chance to reply. So are you getting my example? Jatin, don't take it other way, right? I'm just giving example. I'm just trying to convey two examples that what is the meaning of fundamental right, what is the meaning of directive principle. I always say something, you should do this, you should not do this, students, you go and revise it, do this, do not this. These are things which have been said. But do people follow that always? No. So what is the logic of this point which are not followed perfectly? Which can be followed, which cannot be followed. But fundamental rights are must. Fundamental rights, if we do not follow, if anyone doesn't follow, we can directly file a case to, if you remember this, yesterday we covered this, we can directly go to Supreme Court or High Court. We can directly go and file a case in Supreme Court or High Court. This is the beauty of this topic, right? Are you getting this? Yes. Now, should we go ahead then? Should I teach you now properly? So these were the basic concepts which I have taught you. Should we go ahead? Yes. So now see, the subcommittee of fundamental rights, constituted the assembly, suggested two types of fundamental rights. One which can be enforced, called as fundamental rights. And other which, because of their different nature, cannot be enforced, but they should be done in the country. Okay, now I'll come to the law properly. Main aapko example jo diya abhi class ka wo example tha. Now I will come back to the topic and I'll teach you. Don't worry. Right, again it is written, DP are which are guidelines for the government to lead the country. Very simple line, understand this. Certain directives which are guidelines for the government to lead the country. And very important, please understand and remember, first point, they shall not be enforceable in any court. I told you already also, DPs cannot be enforceable in any court. You cannot file a case against DP, right? But principles laid down are nevertheless fundamental to the governance of the country. Now, if you ask me, sir, please give some examples. I'll give you example. That will be a better way to understand, right? And the directives, however, differ from fundamental rights and FRR, which we have discussed in article number 14 to 32, and DP will start from 37, right? 37 onwards, we will start DP. Now, rather than giving any example, what I'll do is I'll quickly read these points. I'll directly read these points. First, I'll read these points and then I'll come back to the, right? Please understand these points. One. Quickly understand, look, first of all, the state must strive, look very important. The state must strive to promote welfare of people by securing, protecting effectively as it may social order with justice, social, economical and political. What is written? Please understand. The state must strive to promote the welfare of the people by securing and protecting effectively the social order, right? The social order in which we will give justice, social, economic and political. So what happens, and whatever happened yesterday, if you remember, of Vikas Dubey, the encounter of Vikas Dubey, we were discussing yesterday only in the morning. We had a class at 8 to 9 yesterday morning. We were discussing the same thing yesterday morning, and then the moment I end the class and I went to watch the news channel, we got the news that he has been killed in an encounter. Now, whosoever understand the encounter was fake. And why he was encountered? Because he was having the names of so much ministers, the police official, everything. And if he would have arrested and he would have interrogated, उसके साथ अगर पूछताछ होती, उसके साथ अगर पूछताछ होती तो पता चलता कि कितने कितने मंत्री इन्वॉल्व है ना, हाउ मेनी मिनिस्टर्स वर इन्वॉल्व एंड ऑल, विच वी डिस्कस यस्टरडे ऑनली, एंड देन वी गॉट द न्यूज लेटर ऑन दैट ही वॉज किल्ड इन एनकाउंटर, राइट? सो व्हाट इज रिटन हियर, द स्टेट शुड सिक्योर सोशल ऑर्डर फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ वेलफेयर ऑफ द पीपल. वॉज द सेम डन इन द केस ऑफ विकास दुबे? नो सर. Now, very important line. The state shall make sure to try minimize the inequalities. I hope you are listening to this from the childhood only, that rich is getting what? Fill up this line. Rich is getting poor is getting. Fill in the blanks. What's the answer? Perfect Adesh. Good. Some more answers? Simple answer is this. Ilhan, good Ilhan. Where were you yesterday? Ilhan Masum. Rich is getting more richer, poor is getting more poorer. I hope everyone has heard this line. And this gap is increasing day by day. Rich is getting more rich, poor is getting more poorer. It is getting worse day by day. And what is the statement? It is said you need to minimize the inequality. Minimize the inequality. मुझे बता ये आज तक हुआ क्या? Just मुझे बताइए ये आज तक हुआ क्या? क्या कंट्री में पुअर लोग रिच होने लगे क्या? क्या रिच लोगों को नुकसान होना है क्या? कुछ नहीं हो रहा है. So is it coming under DP or fundamental rights? Sir, is it DP? करना है करो, नहीं करना है मत करो. नाउ दिस थिंग, दिस वन, सर्टन प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ पॉलिसी ऑफ अ फॉलोड बाय स्टेट. मैन एंड वुमन शुड बी ट्रीटेड इक्वली. डू यू थिंक इट इज बीन ट्रीटेड इक्वली इन रियलिटी? It is written, the citizen, men and women should be treated equally with have a right to adequate means of livelihood. Both the people should be treated equally. Do you think it is treated equally? Tell me. Then next is, control and ownership of resources of the community are so distributed as to subserve the common goods, so that the resources should be divided. But do you think that the goods in the ration, the poor people, the below poverty line people get the proper goods? Proper things? No. सबसे best line this one. Equal pay for equal work of both men and women. Equal pay for equal work for both men and women. It should be done. Then health and strength of worker and children should not be abused. Should not, please understand. I hope you are getting all these examples. These are all directive principles. मतलब दीज आर ऑल डायरेक्शंस. ऐसा करना चाहिए, ये करो, वो करो, ऐसा करो, वैसा करो. इट इज रिटन लाइक दिस दैट द चाइल्डहुड एंड यूथ आर प्रोटेक्टेड अगेंस्ट एक्सप्लॉयटेशन एंड अगेंस्ट मॉरल एंड मटेरियल अबैंडनमेंट. मतलब पीपल शुड नॉट बी यूज्ड फॉर डूइंग राइट्स. दे शुड नॉट बी व्हाट टू से used for illegal activity, all these things. But then people are doing it. So these are all directive principles. It is given that a state should do this. If they do it, country will run properly. And if you do not do it, sir, we can't help it. Simple. This is the beauty of this topic, that is called as DP. I hope you understood this point. I hope you understood this example, concept, the concept actually, not the example. The concept is very important. What is the meaning of DP and what is the meaning of FR? FR is fundamental rights, which are must, which are superior, top level. And DPs are something which are okay, this third point, okay. The operation of the economic system does not result in concentration of wealth and means of production. Very good, Ilhan. The operation of economic system does not result in concentration of wealth and means of production to the common detriment. Okay. I'll give you one example. There are four companies in country, let's say. Johnson & Johnson, Himalaya, Dabur. Oh shit.